Good morning to all of you. Today we are discussing a decision given by the Chief Information Commissioner way back in 2017 regarding the proceedings of the judicial court. He held that the proceedings and orders and records of the judicial court, they are public records. They can be accessed through the use of Right to Information Act 2005. Normally, the court procedure says, whenever you want any copy of a certain document, you have to file the copy application with some stamp duty. Number one, court fee. Number two, if you are not the person concerned, then if you are not the advocate concerned, you have to file an affidavit in that regard as to what is the necessity for you to obtain the document. That is for the purpose of filing appeal, for the purpose of going for revision, things like that. Normally, third party, they don't give the documents. Now here, with this judgment will be useful for you to say that the judicial proceedings and records are public records and anybody can have access to the same through RTA, because RTA gives an empowerment that you need not tell the cause for which you want to get access or you want to get the documents. So that is the beauty of the RTA Act 2005. Of course, with the basic, you may be knowing the basic concept of the RTA Act is a right to know. A right to know is a fundamental right under Article 21 of the Constitution of India. So they made it because there should be some transparency in the activities of the government, in the activities of the public authority. The public should know as to what is happening. Now, this is relating to the case of Y.M. Prasad versus the Public Information Officer, District Judge, or we can call it as the Evening Court Karak Duma. This is in Delhi itself, New Delhi itself. So, if you want to go through the file, it's, it may be difficult for you, but anyway. So, this relates to file number CIC 3452305423, dated 16/10/2017. If you file this reference, you can get the entire judgment. Here, what happened is Mr. D, the appellant, the Y.M. Prasad, he filed an RTA query, or he filed an application under RTA before the Karak Duma court on 23/7/2015, right? Requesting a copy of the proceedings or notice or summons which happened on the day, on the particular day. So actually he wanted information of the proceedings of the court on 23/7/2015 in connection with the case in which he filed a case against a church. That is, he filed a case against the management of Redeemed Church of Jio, Redeemed Christian Church of God, Janakpuri, before the Municipal Magistrate Karak Duma court he filed. And on that particular date, he wanted to know whether they issued summons, whether given a notice, whether the so-called accused were present in the court or not. For that, to know about the same, he filed an RTI. But it was not replied properly. Actually, this will be sufficient if they have produced a docket order. If the court, the public information of the court, they have given a copy of the docket order saying that I want to A4 present, no representation or something like that, absent, no representation, issue summons, issue and like that. So the docket order would have been sufficient, but they did not give the reply. So then he filed the CPIO, filed the reply on 25/7/2016. Within 21 days only. So he has enclosed the reply stating that in what way you are connected, like that they have asked, and they stated you come to the office and you can have a glance, but we are not going to give a copy of the same. Like this happened. He filed an appeal before the High Court, but nothing happened. Ultimately, he approached the Chief Information Commissioner in 2017. See, he filed the application on actually 27/2016. He wanted to get the information on 23/7/2015, but nothing of that happened. But now the matter has come to the Supreme Court. Chief Information Commissioner. So Chief Information Commissioner, normally after taking it on file, he sent notices to the parties. But as usual, the court people, none of the court people, they were present, they were absent, only appellate is present. Of course, he has explained, he has narrated his entire episode that nothing is happening, court is not taking any steps, they are not giving information to me. Also, all these things are told. Ultimately, having gone through the record, the CIC is satisfied that actually he asked the appellant, that is YM Prasad, he asked for the information of the proceedings on the particular day, that is 23/7/2015. So here he held that the judicial proceedings and records are public records. So the appellant has got even a right to secure the desired information. The court can't say no. So after hearing the appellant and perusal of the record, the commission deems it fit to direct the respondent direct the respondent means court. So to offer inspection of the concerned file to the appellant on a mutual convenient day and time. Of course, the appellant is entitled to avail copies from the record upon payment of the usual charges, and they are given 3 weeks time. So please remember, this will be a good judgment, good order by the Chief Information Commissioner. Please know that the judicial proceedings and public records, the orders and records, they are all public documents. So according to section 5 of the RTI Act, everybody is competent to go through the same. Of course, if they are voluminous or bulky, you can pay the fee and get them xeroxed. If the court, honorable court, does not find time to send the same, you can go to the office and get the same time. This order will be very much useful to you. So if there is possibility, please read the orders of the commissioner, where he held that the public record, the records of the court and the proceedings of the court, they are all public records. It's a direction, good direction, useful for the advocates. Thank you.